Welcome back. Here we have opened the IDLE for you, the IDLE shell, okay, in which we can install. For those who haven't, in which we can write a program. For those who haven't opened, once again, if you want, you can just click, you can just search for IDLE. And once you're done with that, just click on it. And here you have, boom, IDLE opens for you, okay. So here you have the Python 3.4.3 shell out here. Okay, so you may be having a Python 3.6, but this one is an IDLE for Python 3.4.3. Okay, so here we, okay, how do I start off with Python? Okay, I can say, can you see over here three arrows, right? This particular environment of Python where you can write a lot of commands here, this particular environment of Python is called as a shell. This particular shell, you can just give it some sort of command and it pops out for you a reply or a response immediately. It does not wait for you to write down a complete program. This is not a script, but you can write, it is called as an interpreter where you can write your command and it gives you back the response immediately. Well, what are we waiting for? Can I write a command? Yes, anything. Let's say Python for basic calculations. How do I start off with Python for basic calculation? 2 into 3, enter. Oh, it threw back 6 for me. Okay, what about 2.5 multiplied by 6.4? It says 16.0. Wow, that's cool. Okay, so it returns for me something like that. What about 5 plus 6? That's something for addition. What about 5.5 plus 6.3? 11.8. Okay, that's cool. 8 minus 9, it says minus 1. Okay, it gives me some negative answer too. What about 9 divided by 5? For those who have programmed earlier in C, C++, Java, 9 divided by 5 would be something called as a floor division, which would return to them, which would return as an answer 5. The answer would be 1. That means 9 divided by 5. It would just give them the you know, the non-decimal part of it. Okay, so it would have been 1. But what does Python return? It returns for you the answer that is 1.8. So this is an actual division, not floor division. What about Python? Sir, Python, can I write something where, can I write a comment in Python? Yes, you can. You can write a comment saying, hi, you know, this, I'm experimenting with simple calculations in Python. Okay. So you have done some experiments and this is how you do it. So these are your few simple experiments with simple calculations in Python. Okay, can we do something more? All right, so for that, when we get to it, let's do something as to what Python can do with regards to the basic program which is executed by all programming languages when you start. Okay, so what is a basic program that we start when we start with any programming language? What is the first thing that you do? We learn how to print hello world. That's what you do. How do I do it in Python? Is there a way to do it? Okay, it can be as simple as this. Okay, it can be as simple as this in the shell. In the shell, it can be as simple as this. You can just say hello world and it will echo it back for you. Of course, this is not the way you're going to just write hello world. Okay, but sir, I want to print hello world. Okay, I want to see hello world. How do I do it? Okay, for now, I'm just going to help you out with the documentation. I'm going to help you out to understand that Python already has a few functions. For now, if you're not familiar with the terminology, let me call it as a command. Okay, so you Python has a few commands which you can just call and execute your particular program. So how do I do it? In help, there is something called as Python docs. Click on Python docs. It gives you the Python 3.4.3 documentation. Okay, so in the documentation, there is something called as the library reference. Can you click on library reference? When you click on library reference, it tells you something called as a built-in functions. I have a terminology for that, BIFs. Built-in functions of Python. The built-in functions of Python that are there here. Okay, we are going to use them for the built-in functions. We are going to use them for, let's say, we are going to use these commands which are already there in Python. to do a particular task which most people do. Okay, let's see a few built-in functions out here. One of the functions which is of much interest to me is this particular function called as print. Okay, what does print function do? If I click on print function, it says print requires a few star objects. Okay, I don't understand that for now. Okay, let me see what does print does. Print. Okay, it requires a value. It requires a value. What kind of value do you need? Okay, can I say hello world? Can I say hello world? And then return it. It says hello world. Wow. So here you have something called as you called a particular function.